Hello students, so we will continue our whatever nitrogen regarding what beta nitrogen in our P block elements, that is from our group 15 elements. Okay, so see here we will discuss some reaction and you can identify which type of reaction it is. Okay, so see here I am writing here one reaction beta, HNO2 that gives, yes, HNO3 plus 2NO plus H2O. Okay, so these are what our reaction, no doubt it is a balanced reaction only. So in this reaction we have to check which type of reaction it is. Okay, so see here, HNO2, okay, undergoes what beta? Yes, this HNO2 undergoes disproportionation reaction. What beta? Disproportionation reaction. Or we can say, if you heat this HNO2, so what will be the possible products? Okay, it is what, HNO3, then your NO along with water molecule. Now here, how it is this your what? Yes, disproportionation reaction. So see here, as you know, in this HNO2, what will be the oxidation number of N? So you can calculate here easily. So plus 1 plus X plus minus 4, because oxygen 2. So on each oxygen there is a minus 2 charge. So is equal to what? 0. Therefore X is equal to what? Plus 3. Okay. So like that, suppose if you are calculating about your nitrogen here from nitric acid, so you will get how much? Yes, plus 5 your oxidation number, and here in this nitrogen from the nitric oxide you will get how much? Yes, plus 2 oxidation number. So it is very much important to note that when your HNO2, this HNO2 undergoes what? Disproportionation reaction. Means beta, say you can observe here, plus 3 to plus 2 means what? Plus 3 to plus 2 is what? Decrease in oxidation number. And okay, and here from plus 3, okay, from plus 3 to this plus 5 is what? Increase, yes, increase in oxidation number. Means when your oxidation number will decrease, at that time your what? Reduction. And when your oxidation number will increase, at that time what? Yes, decrease means what? Reduction. Increase means what? What? Increase means what? Oxidation. Okay, so here one of the important part about your the disproportionation reaction, when one element undergoes what? Oxidation as well as reduction, we call it as a disproportionation reaction. So like that, frequently they may ask. Okay, now we will discuss here one of the important property of nitrogen. So we can write here as like this: nitrogen has a maximum covalence. So say here, nitrogen has what? Maximum covalence. Covalence of how much? 4. Maximum covalence of nitrogen always 4. Because why it is like this? Because it has, or we can say don't have d orbital. Okay, d orbital electrons or vacant d orbital electrons. So as you know, we can write here as an example as like this, in NH4 plus already we discussed regarding this. Okay, in NH4 plus, okay, then suppose if you are thinking about quaternary ammonium salt, so quaternary ammonium salt is what? Yes, your CH3 4N. You can write this like CH3 4N plus. This also we can show as a what? Maximum covalence of nitrogen is what? 4. And generally beta, you know what? You know nitrogen general valence how much? 3. But your nitrogen can exchange valency, that is covalency, अप टू व्हाट, अप टू 4, ठीक है. सो हियर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट वी विल डिस्कस केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज एंड ट्रेंड्स इन केमिकल रिएक्टिविटी. सही है बेटा, केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज एंड ट्रेंड्स इन केमिकल व्हाट बेटा, रिएक्टिविटी. सो हियर इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज व्हाट, वी विल डिस्कस हियर एनोमलस बिहेवियर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन. In short, what we are going to discuss here, anomalous behavior of what beta, nitrogen. So how here anomalous behavior of nitrogen, because of these reasons. So first reason you can mention here, due to small size, what beta, due to small size, okay. Then high electronegativity. So say here high electronegativity. Third, you can mention high ionization enthalpy, high ionization enthalpy. Okay. Then fourth, you can write non availability of the substrate, or we can say d orbital electrons. Okay, so these are what, these are your anomalous behavior of nitrogen. Okay, means say it has some unique tendency also of your nitrogen. So nitrogen has unique tendency to form what, say you can mention here beta, nitrogen has unique tendency to form what beta, p pi multiple bonds, p pi multiple bonds with itself and with other elements, okay, with other elements having small size, okay, with other elements having what, small size and what, high electronegativity. Okay, it forms what, multiple more, p pi means what, whatever their electrons up to level, okay, they will jump up to your p substrate only, okay, it not exceed their outermost electronic configuration d substrate. Okay, means as you know your nitrogen is what, 1s2 p2 p3, understood? Therefore it forms your what, p pi bondings. Okay, and suppose if you are thinking about carbon, nitrogen, carbon your, then oxygen, that also what? Yes, up to p block elements, okay, up to p subshell. Okay, I hope you understood this thing, high electronegativity. So we can mention like carbon and oxygen, like what, carbon and oxygen. So as you know, like this, you may observe, say triple bond N with itself means N triple bond N with carbon is what, C triple bond N, okay. Then as you know, CO2 also, okay, with nitrogen we want, so say here, okay, say double bond N also, sometimes they are showing like that, what, we can call it as a examples. It has a what, unique tendency to form what, multiple bonds with p pi bonding. Okay, so see here, we will start our next. So as you know, nitrogen exists as a what, N2 molecule, N triple bond N. Okay, so see here, N triple bond N, in that, as you know, वन सिग्मा एंड वॉट बेटा टू पाई बॉन्ड्स, ठीक है, वन सिग्मा एंड टू पाई बॉन्ड्स, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस इट हैज अ वेरी हाई बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एंथैल्पी, ओके, मींस वी अनेबल टू ब्रेक दिस बॉन्ड इजीली, सो इट रिक्वायर्स व्हाट हाई बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एंथैल्पी, ठीक है, देयरफॉर एज यू नो देयरफॉर व्हाट एवर दिस N2, N2 इज व्हाट नॉन रिएक्टिव, नॉन यस नॉन रिएक्टिव, ठीक है, और वी कैन से इट हैज लो रिएक्टिविटी. नाउ हियर अबाउट सपोज वी आर नाउ वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग व्हाट नाइट्रोजन, रफली आइडिया वी डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग दिस नाइट्रोजन, how their anomalous behavior, how a tendency to form compounds with other elements having small size and high electronegativity. Okay. Now what about your phosphorus and rest of the members of group 15 elements? Okay. So see here what will happen about rest of the members of group 15 elements. So that we will discuss here. So you can write down. I hope you are writing. Okay. So see here. Phosphorus, arsenic, bismuth exist in various forms containing okay, we will discuss now how many bonds are between this AS, it is okay, PP containing single bonds, how many bonds beta, a single bonds, okay, you can right as a PP, then AS, okay, then BI, as like this. Okay. So phosphorus, see here, mainly your phosphorus exists as a P4, that is a tetrahedral geometry. So see here, we can show easily as like this. See, as like this here, P4, tetrahedral shape. Okay. So these are about what? What are your other elements? How they are forming a bonding between itself. Okay. Now here, one of the frequently asked question, that is, say, why nitrogen exists as a gas, while phosphorus exists as a solid? So you can write here as a question, why N2 is gas, okay? While phosphorus exists as phosphorus exists as a solid. Okay. So see here why it is like this. So you can think over it why it is like this, why your N2 is a gas and your phosphorus exists as a solid. Okay, so beta, keep in mind here, okay, what will be the reason behind this? See, you must know beta, the single NN bond is weaker than single PP bond, okay. PP bond. So why it is like this? Because high interelectronic repulsion of non-bonding electron. Because high interelectronic repulsion of what beta? Non-bonding electrons, okay, and due to small bond length, as a result what will happen, the catenation tendency of your nitrogen becomes weaker, okay, that's why your N2 is a gas, okay, and phosphorus exists as a solid. So this may reason you can mention, okay, understood. Now in other words, suppose if you are thinking about, so see here carefully, we discuss
single NN bond is weaker than a single PP bond. Okay, now what will be the condition? Okay, since you can write, okay, no doubt this answer is over. Since say PP bond, whatever single PP bond is now weaker, single PP bond is weaker than
what, beta?
Yes, N triple bond A. Understood. Now in this case, you can conclude that yes, your phosphorus is more reactive than nitrogen. Okay. And as you know, beta, white phosphorus, suppose if you are thinking about white phosphorus, so this white phosphorus exists as a P4 only. Okay. White phosphorus P4 is more reactive than N2, and whatever that white phosphorus, it catches a fire immediately. So you can write a reaction also, P4 plus O2. So it will get what, P4 O10 for balancing, like this. You can mention, okay. Means here one more remarkable statement about train you have to mention. Say the reactivity of other elements, say the reactivity of other elements, okay, the reactivity of other elements decreases from arsenic to bismuth. From what? Arsenic to bismuth. Okay. So these are also part you wrote. Okay, you have to write in your notebook. Okay. So we will discuss how and why this your nitrogen does not form P pi D pi bonding. Okay, P pi D pi bonding. Okay. So see here. Nitrogen cannot form P pi D pi bonds, whereas phosphorus, say, as you know, beta, nitrogen does not form P pi D pi bonds. Okay. Whereas phosphorus and other heavier elements, they can form P pi D pi bonds. Okay. P pi D pi multiple bonds. For example, see, phosphorus forms a compound containing P pi multiple bonds, such as see here, it can exist in like this R3P double bond O, R3P double bond CH2, okay, POX3 also, where X is your what? Yes, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Okay. Now, one of the important part is what? Phosphorus and arsenic can also form D pi D pi. Okay, so see here, phosphorus and arsenic can form a D pi D pi bonding with what? D pi bonding with, yes, beta, say here, with transition elements. Okay, understood. D pi, because their atomic number is high, they can extend their electronic configuration up to D subshell. Okay, therefore they are forming compounds with what? Transition elements easily with the help of D pi bonding. One more important reason behind is what? Okay, means as you know, phosphorus, they are forming PCl3 as well as PCl5. Okay, means phosphorus, they can extend up to P pi D pi bonding. Understood. But these also, whatever this, they can extend their electronic configuration up to D subshell and they can form a bonds with transition elements. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now we will discuss, say, reactivity towards hydrogen of all group 15 elements. Okay, after this. Okay,
So see here, we will discuss chemical reactivity towards hydrogen. So you can write here reactivity towards hydrogen. Okay, so see here, reactivity towards hydrogen, okay, of all group 15 elements, okay, all group 15 elements. So here, whatever elements, when they are combining with whatever these your group 15 elements, okay, when they are combining with hydrogen, they are forming a compound as like this, EH3 element, like this, as you know, Nepal, Pakistan, Australia, Sub-Bayman, okay, so from this nitrogen what, NH3, PH3, ASH3, SBH3, BIH3, all hydrides are ready. I hope you understood this. Okay. Now, some other elements also, beta. Some other hydrides having formula. Okay. Some other elements they are forming. As like we saw EH4, but kahi elements molecular formula. Like that also they are forming H2H4. In that you can mention, yes, N2H4, that is hydrogen. Also they are forming, okay, and phosphorus P2H4, that is we can write diphosphine, like that. Okay, AH2H4 also some they are forming, understood. Now nitrogen also form a special type of hydride, so that also we can mention here about your nitrogen, that is HN3. But beta, HN3, so we can write a name as a hydrogen azide, or you can write a name hydrazoic acid. What beta? Yes, here I am writing hydrazoic acid. What these are your HN3. Okay, suppose we will now prepare this, whatever our hydrides are there, we will prepare this. See, without wasting time, we will do preparation of this, our hydrides also. Okay, so pay attention. Here you saw some compounds. Okay, so see here, preparation of trihydrides. What be the preparation of trihydrides? Okay, so see, as you know, these are a normal reaction. In that, so see here, before starting this reaction, concentrate on one part, that is, wherever necessary, you have to break into cations and anions. It becomes very much easy to understanding that reaction, means what is going on actual. Okay, a better way we can what, breaking into that compound cations and anions. Okay, so see here, we will write here one reaction, that is Mg3N2 plus H2O. So what will happen, simple, Mg, as you know, so see here, breaking, plus N is your minus, as you know, N3 minus, water, how it breaks, as you know, H plus and OH minus. So here, yes, old bond will break, new bond will form. So Mg and this OH, so kul mila ke, kya tayar hota hai? Yes, magnesium hydroxide, and this your N and H, yes, as you know, your hydride is ready. Now your work is what, to balance this reaction only, understood. So you can balance, so say I will balance one here, Mg3N2, so say here total six hydrogen, yes, six hydrogens are there, 3 Mg, okay, then here what, 2 NH3, so you can balance, so see here, 3 Mg 3 Mg,
two nitrogen. Yes, here also two nitrogen. Okay, 12 hydrogen. So see here, 6, and here also 6 hydrogen, 6 oxygen. Yes, see here 2 and this 3. So we'll do 3, 6 oxygens are there. So beta, here you can write like this. Okay, wherever necessary you can break easily and you complete your reaction. Okay, suppose I will beta first you write this. Okay, so see here. Suppose I will write here another reaction, C3N2 plus what beta, 6H2O. So obviously here what? Yes, CaOH twice plus 2 ammonia only because here N is 3. So balancing with the help of like this. Okay, no issues in that. I hope you are understanding this, whatever what is going on in our lecture. Okay, and you are removing notes also. Okay, suppose we will discuss here next one. So ready with this. I am writing here one reaction. You have to complete this that reaction with appropriate product. Ca3P2 plus 6H2O. Yes, as you know, calcium here 4 plus, phosphorus is what? 3 minus charge means minus only. Okay. So here as in H plus and OH minus, so old bond will break, new bond will form, then you will get what? Calcium hydroxide. Yes, understood. Plus what? Yes, here you will get PH3. So you can balance H3C3. So like that only balancing. Okay, and suppose if you are preparing one more, we will prepare here. That is, say, zinc, what? Say, Zn3H2, okay? Zn3, what beta? H2. Now here, what will happen? Say, Zn3H2. Plus HCl, then you will get what beta? Yes, ZnNCl. They will join. And what? Yes, metallic, non-metallic part. Okay. Then you will get what? ZnCl2 plus AsH3. Means here, arsenic hydride also we can prepare like this in your reactivity towards. What beta? Reactivity towards hydrogen. Okay. Now we will discuss few more regarding your ammonia. Ammonia is a hydride of nitrogen. Okay. So pay attention on this. What we can discuss regarding this. So as you know beta, ammonia is what? Most important hydride of the group. Okay. And it is extensively used. We can commercially also means whatever preparation of ammonia. Okay, preparation of ammonia from what? Yes, Haber process. Okay. And it is whatever ammonia is extensively used in the preparation of nitric acid. Okay. And therefore we need to prepare this ammonia what? Commercially. And that commercially preparation we can done with the help of Haber process. Okay, it is very much important. Okay, now in this Haber process, so as you know, so many times you wrote in your equilibrium topic also, I think this reaction, see, you will come to know now immediately. Into gaseous plus 3H2 gaseous, what reversible sign, you will get what? 2 ammonia gaseous. Okay, as you know, so many times you wrote this reaction in equilibrium topic also. Okay, I think one more reaction, H2 plus I2, it is reversible by 2HR. Okay, now here, see, and we can prepare industrially by what? Yes, Haber's process. Haber's process, okay. So here one of the most important what is a temperature and pressure condition, also catalyst and whatever your promoter in this reaction. So see, we can mention all. So for that we need to rewrite. You also rewrite this whatever equation again. Say N2 plus price H2. Okay, so see what will be the temperature condition. 652 beta 800 Kelvin. Okay, temperature. And here 350 atmospheric pressure. Here iron is what? Yes, iron is your act as a catalyst. Iron is act as a catalyst, whereas Mu is act as a what? Your molybdenum is act as a promoter, and you will get a final product to ammonia. And their enthalpy value, okay, delta H is equal to, for the feasibility of this reaction, minus 92.4, okay, kilojoule per mole. So this thing is very much important. You have to write this, okay, whatever temperature and pressure condition with what? Yes, with catalyst, okay, promoter, these all are important. Okay, so here we will discuss now regarding phosphine. So how we can prepare, okay, of nitrogen hydride we prepare. So we will discuss here in our syllabus phosphine also there. So we will discuss what reaction of our phosphine also. So be ready with this. So say phosphine can be prepared by heating, okay, by heating white phosphorus with concentrated alkali solution. Okay, so see here about a phosphine. So phosphine, as you know, pH 3, so beta here as like this, P4 plus KH concentrated, okay, plus what? H2O solution. That gives what? Yes, that gives your PH3 plus KH2PO2. Okay, means here we can prepare our phosphine with the help of this reaction. Okay, they may ask question, what will be the formation of phosphine? Okay, what are the products or what are the reactions? Okay, in some cases they may ask about reactants, in some cases they may ask for product. Okay, in the various option forms they will give what. So like that they will ask question, what will happen when white phosphorus reacts with concentrated alkali solution? Yes, your answer must be what? Your phosphine. I hope you understood this. We prepare ammonia, we prepare phosphine. Okay, suppose if you are discussing about structures of this, okay, so we will discuss the structures of ammonia and what, phosphine, okay, and we will discuss about some what important criteria on the basis of this structure. Okay, whether in between bond angle is same or different. Okay, what will happen in the down to the group, in our group 15 elements. Okay, so say, suppose if you are thinking about what beta? Structure. Okay, so be ready about structure. Say, your ammonia is as like this. Okay, your ammonia is like this. Now, the bond angle in between this, how much? 107.8 degree. Now here one of the important part is what? Say, as we move down to the group, bond angle decreases. Because why bond angle decreases? because down to the group atomic size increases. Atomic size increases, understood? So this periodic trend never change, whether you are what? No doubt, in some exceptional cases also there, like that we discussed previous. Okay, in general trend it never change. Means whether your atomic size, electronegativity, ionization, enthalpy, metallic character, non-metallic character, okay, the general trend never change.
Understood? Okay, bond angle decreases. So you can mention beta like this, say ammonia ka kitna hota hai 107.8 degree, then pH 3 also we can mention as like this, okay, then ASH3 also we can mention, SBH3 also you can mention, okay, say BIH3 also. Understood? I hope you understood this. Why decreases down to the group bond angle, okay, of our hydrides, okay? Because what? Whenever if you are discussing about your NH3 and PH3 structure, okay? See. See here, more repulsion and less repulsion. Okay, so see, among this NH3 and PH3 we will discuss. Here also same structure as like this, but here bond angle how much is 93.6 degree. Because see here more repulsion in case of your ammonia. More repulsion, that's why what? Bond angle will increase, and here less repulsion, therefore what? Bond angle is less. Okay, I hope you understood this all. Now we will discuss whatever characteristics of hydrides. Okay, so pay attention on the characteristics of what be the characteristics of hydrides. Okay, see characteristics of what hydrides, whatever NH3, okay, then your PH3. Now see here, regarding first we will discuss here basic strength. What beta? Basic strength. Suppose if you are discussing about basic strength, so as you know, why ammonia is basic, and again see one of the important part, what is the role of that presence of lone pair on that nitrogen, what will be the role of that to donate others, okay? Okay, because of presence of lone pair of electron, nitrogen is what? Basic in nature. Okay, and on the basis of this we can justify, we can write here trend. Say as we go down to the group, the basic character, okay, the basic character of hydrides, what will happen is decreases, basic character decreases. So you may write as like this, NH3, then PH3, Nepal, Pakistan, Australia, so Bayman, as like this. Understood? Okay. Now, why basic character of hydride decreases down to the group? Yes, because what? Metallic character down to the group increases. Or we can mention what? Atomic size down to the group increases. So many reasons we have. Understood? Okay. So, after that, second we will discuss
here characteristics of hydrides in that thermal stability. So here, what about thermal stability? Okay. See, as like this here, thermal stability also decreases down to the what group? Why it decreases down to the group? Yes, atomic size will increase. Understood. So you can mention, you can rewrite this order again, beta. No issues. Understood. Suppose if you are discussing our third is what? Reducing. Yes, reducing character. What about reducing character? What will happen? The reducing character of hydrides of group 15 elements increases down to the group from what? Increases whatever reducing strain, reducing character increases down to the group from nitrogen to what? Bismuth. Okay. Now here your order will different NH3, then your what? Yes, PH3, Australia, Sub, Demon. Okay, like that you can mention. You have to mention, you have to write every time in your notebook. Okay, understood. You have to do consistently about this all content, because all are theoretical in some reaction, reason, okay. Theoretical aspects, important aspects also there, okay. Now, see here, why down to the group increases your stability? Because see, greater unstability of group 15 hydride decreases from NH2 to BIS3. Okay. See, unstability is what? Yes, unstability decreases. Okay. Greater the unstability. Understood. Stability, thermal stability decreases. No doubt. So what will be the unstability? Unstability obviously what? Increases. Okay. Therefore reducing character increases down to the group. Because of unstability. Unstability is greater down to the group regarding your group 15 elements. Okay. Now fourth we will discuss beta. After this. See. Fourth, pay attention on this, about fourth, see, melting and boiling points, what about melting and boiling point? So say NH3 has a higher boiling point than pH3. What beta? NH3 has a higher boiling point than pH, that is phosphine. And okay, increases down to the group, whatever boiling point, say boiling point increases down to the group. Okay, because as you know what, atomic size what beta increases. Understood. Now here, why ammonia has a high more boiling point? This reason, because your ammonia has whatever NH3 it has strong tendency to form what? Strong tendency to form hydrogen bonding with water. Okay, that's why
what? Yes, that's why your ammonia has a more boiling point. ठीक है.
Suppose if you are discussing about solubility. Solubility.
See here, regarding solubility.
So see here, ammonia forms hydrogen bonding. So it will soluble easily. But rest of the members, okay, phosphine and other hydrides does not soluble in water. Okay, because they does not show hydrogen bonding with water. So ammonia is soluble in water while PH3 is insoluble. So you may write a reason here, because ammonia is what? Yes, ammonia it shows hydrogen bonding with water, whereas rest of the members does not form what? Hydrogen bonding. I hope you understood up to this, whatever characteristics of hydrides also. ठीक है. Regarding your melting and boiling point, up to all this contained. If any doubts, you can share immediately, and you have to attend regularly what? Whatever doubt session. ठीक है. Now in next session,
see reactivity towards oxygen.
Okay, so in that whenever group 15 elements, okay, whenever you are this group 15 elements, when they are reacts with oxygen, they may form oxide. Generally two types of oxide they are forming, having formula is what? E2O3 and what? E2O5 is what your element, either your nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, stibium, bismuth. Okay, so see here, we will make a one column as like this, elements.
Okay, see here, elements, then
elements here and oxidation states with a downside. Say as like this,
here plus 1, okay, then plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, and what beta? Plus 5. See here, nitrogen, okay, see, nitrogen of element what? Nitrogen, then phosphorus, arsenic, okay, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, stibium, then your what? Bismuth.
You can make column and you can prepare. Okay, so these are what oxidation numbers are ready. So as you know, oxidation number plus 1 is what? Your N2O. Okay, plus 2 is what? Your NO. Then here N2O3. Then here what? N2O4, N2O5, N2O5. Okay, about phosphorus also we can write beta. Okay, generally phosphorus starting with what? Plus 3 oxidation number. So here what will happen? P4O6 phosphorus trioxide, because beta it is what? Dimer of this P2O3, so keep in mind this. Okay, P4O6, then here what? P4O8, okay, P4O5, as like this, then like here S2O3, okay, about what? S2O5, then about SB2O3, then here what? Bi2O3, SB2, see here beta, SB2O5, Bi2O5, like that. oxides you need to draw in this table.
Okay, and generally what will happen? Beta, down to the group, acidic character decreases, means from nitrogen to, yes, nitrogen to bismuth. Okay, so these are what about your acidic character. Generally what will happen, beta? More the oxidation number, more is the acidic strength of that oxide. Okay, so here you have to complete this whole table. Okay, you need to revise from first onwards whatever going on our in our P block elements. Thoroughly you have to read NCERT also, because it is very much important. Like that I told about in coordination compounds also. Okay, you need to revise your NCERT, then in text question, exercise questions, okay, you need to solve. Okay, so next part we will discuss in our next lecture. Thank you very much.